What's up, peers, and welcome to the reading of the OpTech newsletter. OpTech newsletter number 0, June 8th, 2018. This newsletter from June 8th, 2018 was a brief rerun of the OpTech newsletter. Technical news about Bitcoin from last Friday to this Thursday, June 1st through June 7th. Summary. A new maintenance release of the Bitcoin Core is coming soon with a change to relay policy. Hash rate has been increasing rapidly, so it could be a good time to send low fee transactions. Wallet providers may want to investigate proposed BIP 178, that's partially signed Bitcoin transaction, before it is fully implemented. Filters for peer-to-peer lightweight clients are heavily discussed. Feedback is requested on proposals to change private key serialization and how mining pool communicate with their hash rate, with their hashers, and Bitcoin Core merges an optimization to build Merkle trees up to 7 times faster. Key action items. Check for use of the code separator opcode Bitcoin Core 0.16.1, expected to be released within the next week or so, will no longer relay legacy, that is non-SegWit transactions, using this opcode. As far as Bitcoin Core contributors know, nobody uses this opcode. But if your organization does use it or plan to use it, you should immediately contract a protocol developer or the OpTech team members as soon as possible to inform them of this use. Ultimately, it is possible that this opcode will be removed from the Bitcoin protocol for legacy transactions via a soft fork. Test release candidates for Bitcoin Core version 0.16.1, RC1, is available now, and RC2 is likely to be available shortly. This release will contain bug fixes, in particular important for miners. There are no major changes for spender, receiver, and API providers, but they may benefit from the bug fixes. Dashboard updates. Hash rate increases. The difficulty of mining increased almost 15% this week, and short-term average of network hash rate show continued growth. This means that blocks are being produced more frequently than normal, and this will likely hold down transaction fees for as long as this trend continues. It is a good time to consolidate transaction outputs or otherwise send low-fee transactions. Very low-fee transactions. An increase in the number of very low-fee transactions paying less than 10 nano bitcoins per virtual byte has been observed on nodes with non-default transactions. Acceptance policy. The default policy is to reject transactions paying less than 10 nano bitcoins per virtual byte. This may indicate misconfigured wallets paying fees that are too low, or it may indicate that some spenders believe this is a viable strategy to save on fees. It may be worth experimenting to determine whether these extremely low fees can be used for consolidations and other time incentive intra-wallet transfers. News. BIP 174, again, that is the partially signed Bitcoin transaction. Discussion and review is ongoing. This BIP creates a standardized format for wallets to reliably share information related to unsigned and partially signed transactions. This is expected to be implemented in Bitcoin Core and may also be implemented in other wallets, allowing software wallets, hardware wallets, and offline, that is cold wallets, to easily interact with each other for both single signature and multi-signature transactions. This BIP has the potential to become an industry standard And so all major wallet providers are encouraged to investigate the specification. The proposed implementation of BIP 174 was previously added to Bitcoin's core high priority review queue and receives significant discussion this week, with at least one bug being found and one protocol developer suggesting that parts of the proposal can be split up. BIP 157 and BIP 158 lightweight client filters. These BIPs allow nodes to create a compact index of transaction data for each block on the chain and then distribute copies of that index to light clients who request them. The clients can then privately determine whether or not the block might contain any of the client's transaction. Exactly what data should be indexed was heavily discussed on the mailing list this week. This probably does not directly affect most large receiver, spender, and API services, but any providers planning to release wallets using the peer-to-peer network protocol may want to review these BIPs. Bitcoin Core pull request number 13,242, merged this week, is part of an effort to bring this feature to Bitcoin Core. And by the way, this inverse Golem Rice filters are used in the Neutrino clients, which are used for Lightning wallets and the Wasabi wallet. Proposed BIP for private key and hierarchical deterministic wallet serialization. Currently, private keys are usually transmitted using the same encoding as legacy Bitcoin addresses, and hierarchical deterministic wallet extended keys and seeds are transmitted using either the same format, a hex, or a mnemonic phrase. This new proposal would allow using BEC32 format used for native SegWit addresses. The discussion focuses on whether or not to use the exact BEC32 standard or a modification of it so that it would be more resistant to transcription and data loss errors. Services that plan to accept or distribute secret key material may wish to contribute to reviewing the specification. BetterHash mining protocol. A proposed replacement for the Stratum mining protocol, currently almost universally used for mining pools, to distribute work to individual miners. The proposal claims to provide better security for the pool operators and allows individual miners to select what transaction they include in their candidate block, increasing Bitcoin censorship resistant and also the possibility making miners using the protocol more efficient. The protocol is championed by the developer and operator of the fiber network, used by almost all miners. The protocol has been in semi-private development for some time and is just now being distributed for public comments. Organizations planning to sell or operate mining equipment are encouraged to review this protocol. As are any groups or individuals desiring changes to Bitcoin's consensus rule so that the protocol can potentially be made forward compatible with those changes. There has not yet been much on-list discussion for the proposal. On this day, Bitcoin commit history, 2017, Andrew Chow authored the commit so-and-so, paving the way to remove the last part of the confusing safe mode functionality added to Bitcoin version 0.3 and after the value overflow incident. In 2017, Luke Dash Jr.'s pull request was merged, adding support for BIP9 version bits to the get block template RPC call, allowing miners to signal support for future soft forks, such as the soft fork that activated BIP 141, segregated witness. User activated soft fork, everyone. We won that war. Oh, yes, we did. 2015, Gavin Andreessen authored the commit to refine the criteria a node uses to detect that it may no longer be received blocks from the best blockchain. 2014, Cos Lohan authored a commit removing a legacy part of the GUI, graphical user interface, that assumed that any transaction fee below 0.01 Bitcoin was a low transaction fee. Oh, back then this was a low transaction fee, okay. 2013, Vladimir van der Laan authored a commit fixing a bug related to the data directory. In 2012, Luke Dash Jr. authored several commits related to enabling IP version 6 support. 2011, 10, and 2009, no commit dated on June 8th. Pierce, thank you very much for joining me here in the reading of the very first Bitcoin Optech newsletter, number 0, issued on June 8th, 2018. And I especially want to thank all the contributors to the Bitcoin Operations Technology Group who provide this plethora of high noise and no bullshit research. And I thank you very much for all the work you do. And Pierce, see you on the next show. Bye-bye.